Hi guys, it's me, Jimmy Geek. So the question is that, is CWNP certification worthless? Hey Jimmy, I love watching your video. Considering IT, Internet of Things and cybersecurity, I would love to read your own thoughts and opinion about the CWNP.com certification. People say to me that www.i3c.org, CIS and CSSP cover everything. They also say that CWNP certification are useless and they will die soon. Briefly, my background is in computer science. I did a 4-year computer science degree. Then I worked for IT and then information system for 10 years, mainly ERP software implementation. I'm not a computer programmer for sure. I want to know if there is a career to be made in wireless world before I do anything. I want to read about your thing. I will say first move to a screen, then I can show you about this. So you can see that CWNP or worthless certification. I will get a Cisco one, Cisco wireless, and then get a CCNP, I mean Cisco certified network professional and wireless. The problem is that yes, one day they will die. There was another sysadmin from India, 4 years he worked his ass off, now he want to commit to like programming or want to change his career to another career in IT. I mean, nowadays tech is like, I mean, becoming more and more hard. IT guy are not getting the same respect like they got back in 2000 or 2005 even. Personally, my opinion is that CWNP are worthless. Become Jimmy a geek. I never ever heard of this certification before. I never ever heard of this certification before. I know a lot about networking stuff. I mean, to be honest with you, I did a lot of network as a freelancer. I dive into every stupid certification shit I can, but I never heard. So it just make me wonder who really know. Stay away from it. Look into programming. You can buy some like learn PHP to be able to become a PHP web developer where the money is, or become an Android Java developer. To be honest with you, computer network career will die. We will need few network engineers unless you are CCIE or you're some kind of specialized. And then for a wireless, again, my opinion, I have two opinions. Some people think only you need to have one. I have two opinions because I'm Jimmy. I like to have two opinions sometimes. One opinion is that wireless, I mean, will take over the world because it's less headache. But when wireless take over the world, remember one thing, you really need few manpower to implement and manage it. I mean, for example, like 10 after one only you need like a network guy, a computer network technician or engineer. But even it doesn't take over, my second opinion is that it will not take over because wireless have some a lot of problems. The biggest problem no one really want to talk about, how to say male infertility, is that the right word? I can't speak. I mean the problem is that wireless or Wi-Fi waves, I mean, make male he can't produce, I mean babies, to be honest with you, in an easy word. So there's like a strong campaign ongoing to revert back to, I mean, internet cable to a hard, I mean, network rather than going wireless. And then that is a reality. I mean, but science of producer, a lot of network engineers do not have babies. They never can produce babies because, of course, you get a scientific point. I don't want to go into more detail. I really started hurting a lot against wireless stuff. For example, forget that stuff. I mean, make sure that you understand what really wireless is. Wireless is having going something on an air, it's a wave. The networks were made as a military tool to communicate. It was a hard network. Even still today, all of the network internet are used are hardwire. That's it. I mean, for example, why are we not using wireless network? I mean, for example, I was just reading a news that Russia, I mean, people think Russia is going to cut the internet wires, I mean, under the sea. Not a bullshit propaganda. Anyways, I'm not a fan of Russia, but it is a propaganda. But I mean, Again, if for example you think that Russia is going to cut the internet wires, I mean undersea, why are you not, I mean, implementing wireless? They have been, one of my instructor told me that I never, I mean, read into it that they use mirror to, I mean, transmit the beams of signal. It's like more technical, like engine telecommunication engineer stuff. But the problem is that we really can't, I mean, achieve full wireless world because we always need hardware. Hardware is, I mean, billion times more reliable than wireless. Wireless a frequency issue. Even our wireless network is very easy to hack. No one want to talk about. A physical network is very hard to hack. If you want to hack a physical network, you need to plug into it. If you want to hack a physical network, an internet cable network, you need to plug something into it. Or you can, of course, you can hack, I mean, over the internet, but you need to go into the main domain, which is internet. For wireless network, the signals are, I mean, just flying on the air. I mean, the frequency easily can be hacked. I mean, there are bazillion tools to do it. My personal opinion, next 5 years start going down, and then internet of things, I mean, you are asking me about the internet of things. I will be saying that Internet of Things, currently I'm doing my certificate of Internet of Things of University of California. I will make sure to check out a link. I'm doing that. Even you can see my certificate on the screen. I have just completed my one of my certificate. Problem is that I'm learning Internet of Things. I'm learning to build Arduino Raspberry Pi project, but the problem is that I don't know how to monetize it, or I don't know how to sell it. Maybe I will figure it out. I will write a book, or I will try to make a course how to produce it. The problem is the Internet of Things are really good idea. Internet of Things like a dot-com boom, it's a mine. There's $1 billion into it, but how anyone can tap into it? Cybersecurity, stay away from bullshit. If you get a cybersecurity degree, there are very few jobs, very few bloody jobs for cybersecurity. Very competition, I mean, it's a very competitive niche. A lot of competition, stay away from that. Just look into programming. I hope this answers the question. 5 year, maximum 10 year, I mean, by 2020, I mean, like, I mean, there will be like, I mean, 20 to 30% cut for the network engineers. So it's much better you try to look into programming. I will say my personal opinion. Coding not bloody hard. Coding not hard. Coding not easy. Coding is coding. Coding every day. There's nothing, I mean, rocket science to it. If you know 2 plus 2, it's simple coding. I don't know. Again, people think cybersecurity is worse. The worst of all. A lot of people ask me why I'm anti-cybersecurity. I work in the real world. People think that, I mean, I joke about. I work in enterprise. Make sure to watch my enterprise video. How an enterprise look like. I did a tour of enterprise. I record and vlog on it. Problem is that no one really want to hire a penetration tester. To be honest with you, it's worthless. No one will give you a bloody job unless, I mean, you are a big company or there's a hack happen. Even since they will try to hire like computer scientist rather than hiring a cybersecurity guy. I hope this answers the question. It's me, Jimmy. Bye.